trespasses. Father, you ask you to overlook, Father, and that you not allow me to come in thy presence, Jesus. Not only me, Father, but all of us in this house this morning to come in thy presence.
Yes.
And be mindful of how great you are, Master. Father, we ask you to search our hearts, Lord. Anything that's not desirable to your will, Lord, that you remove it, Father. Father, we ask, Father, that you would also, Father, allow your anointing to fall on each one of us, Master. We ask for your strength, and we thank you, Master.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name we ask.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time. You know, not even though times are tough and it's life is rough, but I know I've got a good God. He didn't promise me that I'd have it easier on this side, but he did promise me I'd make it through. And I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful for him. Because we just come out of talking about Joseph and how Joseph had to endure. And we have to endure, but we can hold on because Jesus made it possible for us to be able to hold on. Amen. I'm going to try to keep it short. Introduction this week, but what is our anchor scripture?
Mark 12:30.
And we just gonna leave off 31 for a while because we got to make sure we get 30 right. Because if you can't get, you know, and the good part about getting 30 right, if you can get 30 right, you can have 31. Amen. Who's going to volunteer to read that for me? Who would? Yes, sir. Go ahead. Yes.
And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment.
Amen.
Love God all my heart. All our mind. And you know, Satan wants the mind, you know. The thing about the mind, if you can get the mind, you can keep it, you can have a person depressed, keep him downhearted. But if you give God your mind,
yes,
he promised he'd uplift you and he would see you through.
All right.
He said, all things work for together for those who love God and call according. Uh-huh. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to look at 1 Corinthians 15, verse 33. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 33. I didn't see it right this time. I hope I got it that time. And even though, you know, and the thing, you know, the good thing about it is I realize I've got a good God. But then there's some tough spots in between and all. But what happened? I'm finding I'm trying to relay that you can make it through with God. Mm-hmm. It really doesn't make any difference what you come up against, and that's a good thing about the word. We see how God has kept His promise. We saw how God kept His promise to Joseph. We see how God kept His promise to David, and we see how God kept His promise to Joshua. And we see how God kept His promise to Abraham.
Amen.
We just see how God over and over keeps His promises. And we really keep in mind we have a God that cannot lie.
Amen.
And He's able, church. And that's what, you know, that's what we have to keep in mind, that He's able to handle that. And when you get the First Corinthians, you'll find this there. It says, be not deceived. Be not deceived. Bad communication messes up bad morals. Mm-hmm. Okay. Say it again. It says, be not deceived. Mm-hmm. For bad communication corrupts good morals. I did write that down, right? Mm-hmm. Did you? All right. I want to make sure. He said, now, you say, that's what got Eve in trouble, right? She got into a conversation with the devil.
Yes.
And so she got bad communication, evil communication. And church, that's what we have to. And I, you know, even though even though things are tough, and even though you're going through, you have to take your content and your peace from God. Say it again. Even though things are not going the way that you want them to go, you have to take your strength, and God promises that, church, that he will give us strength, you know, that he will take care of us, and that he will stand with us when everybody else walks away. You know, that's what God promised us. And God's a God that's able to handle it, church. No matter how you look at it, or how you think about it, and see, the good thing about it, some of us has come over the hills and the valleys, and God, this is not the first time we've been into a valley. This is not the first time we've been on the hilltop.
All right.
But the good thing about that is, every time God has saw us through. He saw us through when we was on the mountaintop. When everything was going well, he saw us through.
All right.
Yeah. And when everything was going downhill, he saw us through.
All right.
And the good thing about, and that's why I keep trying to tell you, that's why you can't let people dictate how you feel. You have to keep taking that to God. Because God got a promise for you. And it's just hold on to what God said. That's what you got to hold on to. You can't hold on to the mess that people put you through. You got to hold on to what God said. And when you hold on, because it's the word, church. It's not my word. It's God's word. And that's the thing. It's God's word. And what happened when you began to get God's word in you, you realize that this old place here is just for a few days, church. It's just for a short time. Yeah, this is not forever. So we have to keep in mind to keep our minds set on Jesus.
All right.
Because he's coming back, and he's coming back for the church. And, yeah, and if you don't get it right on this side, won't be no getting it right on the other side.
All right.
It's important. It lets us know. And it's his word. It says evil, being around evil people. Evil, that's what got Eve in trouble.
Never.
And that's what got Joshua in trouble.
Never.
That's what got Achan in trouble. You remember Achan, right? Yeah, when God told him to go down and take care of Jerusalem, yeah, God told him that. Said, "Well, I want you to do. I want you to go to Jericho. Go to Jericho, and I want you to destroy everything in Jericho. Everything belongs to me." Yeah, he said, "Everything sacrificed to God." He said, "That belongs to me." So what I want you to do, I want you to go to Jericho, and I want you to destroy everything down there. But what Achan got down and decided he wanted to put his hand on God's stuff. And when you start putting your hand on God's stuff, you got trouble, church.
Amen.
You can believe it or not, you got trouble. But it's just evil. And so God is letting us know that now. And listen to me. God, I'm gonna keep it short. Because we pray for everybody's lost loved one. And people are leaving just like flies, church.
All right.
It's not like they, you know, you got your one month. No, but you got 3 or 4 a day.
Amen.
With people we know, not in the world. You got many thousands in the world, but people we know.
Right.
Go on home.
Yes.
And listen to it. So I keep telling you, I'm getting more interested in leaving here than I'm staying.
Uh-huh.
Because when I leave here, things are gonna get better. Paul said, I'm torn between.
Yes.
Staying here or leaving. All right. Yeah, and listen, we gonna leave.
Uh-huh.
Don't think you're going to stay here forever.
Oh,
yeah, you got to leave. Hey, everybody in here got an appointment with the
yes,
with the maker.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, he's going to call the road.
Uh-huh.
And he already know when he's going to call it in.
Yeah.
And listen, and what the thing about it is, it shouldn't be no fear in our hearts. Because what that? But why should there be no fear in my heart? Because I've got God in my heart.
Uh-huh.
And God tells me, if I got him in my heart, I'm good.
Yes.
Yeah, it doesn't make any difference. I keep telling myself that. It doesn't make any difference of what the world is saying.
Yes.
It's what God says, church.
Yes.
And what God says is going to hold, it's going to hold out. It'll hold water.
Yes.
Yeah. If you hadn't tried it, you ought to try it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if you don't know him, you need to get to know him.
Yes, sir.
Because he's coming back. And he's looking for you. Mm-hmm. He's looking for me. And then you know what? We're going to stand and we're going to give an account for everything we've done on this side, church.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and really, yeah, even though the trial and tribulation hard, the heartbreaker, broken heart, although it's hard, broken heart, but God said, That's the only one can prepare a work on a broken heart, church. It's God. Yeah, yeah. Your heart broke. Give it to God.
Yes.
Yeah. If you're going through something, give it to God.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Hey, but let me tell you this. But hold on to God. Don't let evil communication. Evil sits in the way of God. God tells us how to line up. Yeah. Don't let the evil take over your mindset. Don't let evil control you. Because God tells us how it's going to turn out. And that's why I keep trying to tell people, get in the Word. Get in the Word. I got about five. I'm not going to take long this month. But I just want to get in the Word. And see what God will do for you. Don't be messing around. And listen, I tell you this now. Because what will happen is, God will give you more power to oversee.
All right.
And listen to me. We serve a God that got all power. We serve a God that does never run out of power. We serve a God that spoke the earth in existence in 6 days, church. Right. If he can do this, and not only that, made man in that 6 days. Uh-huh. And all the infinite parts that we've got, all the greatest our bodies is, great as it is, and God did that all in 6 days. So this little junk we go and handle now don't mean nothing to God.
All right.
God can handle it, church.
Yes, sir.
But it keeps us stay out of evil communication. And why? That's why you need to be in the Word of God.
All right.
Because that's where you got to be to get your strength. That's what you got to do. You got to be in the Word of God. You cannot get your strength walking the street, talking to strike, smack. You got to get it from God.
All right.
And it shall keep telling you. And the devil don't want you to know that. You know what? They'll want you to go to hell.
Yes, sir.
And that's what he's working on. And he wants the church to go to hell. But he can't do that because the Word tells us, God said, when I left here,
all right.
He's at the gates of hell.
Yes,
right. See, the church, and that's the only thing. We've only got the good news, church.
All right.
And we've only one got the good news.
Yes, sir.
Because everybody else, if you're not saved, if your name not in the book of life, you're going to hell.
Yes, sir.
Hell, down there, wherever it is.
Yes.
But God said, I prepared it for the one that has not took my son as being their Lord.
Yes,
he said, hell, the burn forever and ever.
Yes, sir.
You know, hell. Mm-hmm. You ever been burnt? You ever see how they got yesterday? Mm-hmm. Then you walk outside, you can hardly take a breath.
Yes, sir.
And just think, when you say hell, you want
10,000 hearts.
Oh, yeah. Evil communication. And listen to me. Even though the heart pain, even though the heart ache, there's a joy there because I know God got it under control.
All right.
Yeah. There's a joy because I know he's got it under control. And he's going to handle it, church. Yeah. You can't see it, but that's all right. But it says faith is a substance of things not seen. You got the faith? Yeah. So if you got faith, you got to be able to hold on. Yeah, and God's going to handle it. And what happened is God reinstalled. You know, everything was going good, but God reinstalled. And when God reinstalled, everything's going to be all right. All right, come on now. Mm-hmm. Let's see what we got here. Ephesians. Let me get a reader here. So, Sister Duckworth, you did so well on that other one. Ephesians 5:6. And Sister Burden the 7. Ephesians 5. Yeah, and see, y'all mess around and think I'm reading out a different book than y'all reading out of. Yeah, that may be because, and that's why I try to keep you looking at the book. Because my little old self can't get send you to hell. I don't have no power. But what I want to do, I want to make sure you know where to find it at. And I want you to find it in the book. And then when you find the book, you're responsible for that. Oh, yeah, he's a good God.
Amen.
Yeah, he's able. Are you there? 5:6. 5:6.
Okay. Verse 6, Ephesians 5, let no man deceive you with vain
words. Hold on a minute. No man. I want you to see it in the Word, church, because that's what you got to do with it. That's where it's coming from. It's the Word. It's what Jesus said. It's not what I say. That's in your Bible. Are you looking in your Bible? Except that, no, let no man, I don't want to deceive you, vain. Never, ever. Because what? Once you know the word, that's why I keep trying to say, no, don't you know no word. Say, no, don't you know the word. Because once you know the word, you've got power. What did Jesus do? He said, it's written, man shall not live by bread alone, but everything out of mouth, God's mouth. Said, don't let no man deceive you by vain. Is it in the word? Am I talking out of the word? Is it in the Bible? Is it in the Bible? It says it's there.
Amen.
Look at it there. Look, I want to make sure it's there.
Amen.
I want you to know it's in the Bible.
Amen.
Because that's what we're living by. This is the word of God. I want you to know that. Yeah. But don't let nobody. No, don't let nobody send you to hell. And then that's why I said, then when you know the word of God, it becomes your responsibility. Your responsibility to do that. Yours. Not nobody else, but yours. To do right by God. Whatever belongs to God is God. Don't play with God's stuff. God owns it. Everything you got, God owns it. And he's allowed you to be steward of it just for this while. Just for a little while. And you got to give it in charge of that. You got to give an account for that. Don't let nobody go along and say, what on that? You finish it.
By because of these things cometh the wrath of God.
Wrath of God. Now, listen, this little pain you have now, the wrath of God, you ought to ask Solomon and Noah what happened. The wrath of God. You ask the one that got on Moses' toe. And what happened there? Said the earth opened up, swallowed them up.
Yes, sir.
Now, you think you messed with something? You better. No, God, I'm talking about God, not man, God. Jesus Christ, Lord, the one died so you could be so you could have salvation. The one died that you could have peace and have an opportunity of salvation. The one that died, church, that's what I'm talking about. He's able. And listen, and the word says he sees just as good in the dark as the night. That it doesn't get dark in God's sight.
Yes, sir.
I'm talking about Jesus.
Yes, sir.
And the word, the word, church. That's what you got to live by. You don't let man fool you.
Yes, sir.
But don't let no man put you there.
Yes.
Because you got to give an account. You,
yes,
you,
sir.
You.
Yeah.
And I.
Yes, sir.
I hate to use I many times, but you got to give an account.
Yes, sir.
And you're going to give an account.
Yes, sir.
You got a guy that keeps good records.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. That one dot, not one little part of his work. It's going to get out, church.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Here they go. Going to say, what on that? Did you finish that?
Upon the children of disobedience.
Disobedience. And that's why you know what God says. You know what it says. And you know how to act right. God says it.
Yes, sir. Talk about it.
That's who says it. Mm-hmm. And not me. I ain't got to give an account for you. I got to give an account for me.
Amen.
I got to stand before God myself. And you got to stand before God for yourself. And when he calls your name and asks you what you've been doing, what you've been doing, how you been acting?
Yes, sir.
Are you living right? Are you doing right? Are you doing what the word said? Not what our retailer said, the word.
Yes, sir.
What it said.
Yes, sir.
Now, you better straighten up.
Mm-hmm.
And that old folks fly right.
All right.
Because God, sir, God. Right. It's not me, God. Now, you can do what you want to do, but it's in the Word.
Yes.
It's in the Word, church. The Word.
Yes, sir.
Now, you act like you want to act, but it's in the Word.
Yes,
and the Word is stuff. It's, the Word tells us not one jilt, not one tilt of the Word will get away.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it's going to be there, church.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah, but God's good.
Amen.
And listen, he's kept me, let me tell about myself. He let me stay on the earth long enough to be able to say, I don't want to act a fool no more.
Uh-huh.
I want to spend more time trying to please God than acting a fool.
Yes, sir.
I'm talking about myself now.
Yes,
you do what you want to do. That's what I've decided. I decided I want to be trying to make sure I go home to be with Jesus than I just want all the stuff I got here.
All right.
Oh, he's been good.
All right. Yes, sir.
He's been good.
Yes, he is.
Yeah, he's been good. And I'm not going to hell for you.
Uh-huh.
I'm not going. All I need to do is tell you.
All right.
Yes, then when I tell you that that's my job.
All right.
That's my job to tell you.
All right.
If you act the fool, my job is to tell you act the fool to tell you to stop.
All right.
That's what I'm. That's what I'm told to tell you.
Talk about it.
Yeah, that's it. Uh-huh. That's all I'm supposed to say. Did you finish that, Sister Delbert?
Not yet, therefore, partakers with them.
Don't be that. What is it? Y'all, is that in y'all book?
Yes, sir.
It said, don't be partakers. Don't be partakers with them. If they act the fool, let them go and act the fool by themselves.
All right. Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Don't let nobody take your hell.
All right.
Don't let. And Sister Bird, it starts off with what on your 7 says what?
She read 7.
Okay, read 7 again then. I want to hear it again. We didn't hear it again.
Partake. Be not ye, therefore, partakers.
Okay, now that's about stop right there. Thank you, Sister Bird. Thanks, Sister Bird. Is that in the planer? Mm-hmm. Don't be partakers of that. It tells us that evil spirit. Yeah, evil communication. I'm about ready to quit. I got about 4 more, and I don't think I'm going to quit. Yeah, pick up. We need to get serious, sir.
Amen.
God got some birthing to do here. Mm-hmm. He got some cleaning to do, too.
Yep.
But he got some birthing to do. Yeah. He's got to grow pregnant with some stuff, but we got to move some stuff.
All right.
Yeah, move some stuff. I don't know how long it's been. How long it's staying. But I know it's time to go.
Right.
And that's my prayer. And listen, I need to be feeding the whole flock, not one or two.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I want the whole flock. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Proverbs. Yeah, probably the last one. I think Proverbs 13 and 20. Who want to do that? Brother Brian, you sitting over there quiet. Come on. Do the 13. Proverbs 13, I'll give you time. And I'll talk a little bit more. Give me a little bit more, a few more minutes there while you find it. Proverbs 13, verse 20. Listen, Jerry.
Yes.
Come on then.
Proverbs 13, verse 20. He that walketh with wise men.
Oh, wait a minute. Well, who are you going to be? Hey, who are you going to walk with?
Wise men.
Yeah, and if you kind of get back in there, it's if you want to know how to make a good living, look, go to the end. You know what the end does? Every time, and that's a bad thing. Like, you drop something, ain't going to find it.
Amen.
You mess around and you drop something sweet in your house, next thing you know, you got in. And that's what it's telling us, church. That's what it's telling us. If you want that, go to the end. See how they do it. That they gather in the summertime. They gather when it's summer.
Yes.
When it's hot, when it's time together.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. He said, wise men and women. Yeah, that woman in that bird. That women. Wise men and women. Yeah, they did say women, but that's what it referring to that. Walk with wise. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Because God is good, church.
Amen.
And he loves, you know what else about it? He loves us. He loves his church. He gave his son for his church.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Master.
Yes, he did. He loves us. And he says, I don't want nobody to go to hell.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, but he said, I'm not going to make you go to heaven.
Yes, sir.
If you don't want to go to heaven, go to hell.
Yes.
Stay. As a matter of fact, you go and stay.
Uh-huh.
Long as you want to. Because you got to. You know why? Because you won't be getting out. How you know that? Because remember the rich man who died?
All right.
He went to hell.
All right.
Yeah, he said, well, I want to come. Would you sit loud and touch my tongue?
Yes, sir.
He said, yeah, no, that's it. You had your good time. He said, now, but listen to me. You better enjoy it here.
Yeah.
And if you're not saved, but enjoy it here. Because that's the only heaven you'll see, church.
Uh-huh. Yes, sir.
And he goes on and say, wise man. What goes on and say, what now?
He that walks with wise men shall be wise.
Yeah, so what? Listen, go back to what he said now. Evil communication corrupts good manners. But then the Proverbs tell me, and that's why when you spend time laboring for God, spend time in the Word of God and see what He wants you to do, that's why you can have power. That's why you can see things when other people are running around looking. That's why, because God loves showing His charity.
Right.
He loves giving up, putting us on the right direction.
Right.
He loves being loving up. He loves it, church. Don't you know it ain't a good father? Love to do right. And you know what we got? We got a good father.
All
to do right. Oh, he's good to me. I've been, but listen to me. He's good. Now, you can act like you want to act, but he's good. And he's going to see what's going on. Then he goes on and say, what now?
But a companion of fools shall be destroyed.
What? What read that again? That might not be in the word. Read that. What? Start from the again. That might not be there. He said, what now? What did it say? Yeah, come on. He might be reading the foreign writers, foreign song. This might not be in the word of God. Do you think it is? Do you really believe it? Wait a minute. Let's make sure we know where he's at. He's in Proverbs 13 and 20. That's what I'm going to make sure we all know that, right? Proverbs 13 and 20. So in case Brother Brown might not be reading that book right, we want to see, all of us want to look at that so we can see that wise man. Yeah, wise man do you pay your card on? Lord said, you need to talk about money. And I guess what I'm going to really start talking about money. But he said, now, do you pay your, I'm getting on. Do you pay your credit card off every month? You know I do. If you charge it, you need to pay it off.
Amen.
Every month.
Amen.
Yeah, when it comes, you need to write a check. Don't charge no more on your, I'm getting out of off that, but I'm going to. Yeah, you said, wise man. I need to learn how to keep time already, but I'm working on it. Okay. Listen. But everybody get there. Proverbs 13, 20. Everybody there?
Amen.
Well, I want to make sure it's in your book. And I want to make sure you know where to find it at. Because if it shouldn't, and then you say, well, he didn't tell me. You got a Bible?
Amen.
If anybody out there don't have a Bible on your phone, you can't look at it on your phone, you ain't got a Bible in your hand. Mm-hmm. If you don't have one, because I want to make sure you know I'm not trying to pull your leg. Mm-hmm. I want you to make sure that I'm not telling you something that the world don't tell me. Yeah, because we got a good God. And God want to grow. But he cannot grow when old grow doing stuff he's doing.
All right.
He can't grow. Yeah. And in fact, God has birth and old grow to birth. But now, and it's too much stuff. See, it's too much stuff to handle. You can't handle 3 or 4 cents. And then God turn around and let you be handling millions.
Right.
See, that's you won't be able to handle that.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah. See now, and that's what God's trying to tell us. If you want to birth what I want you to birth, you get it right, then I'll show you how to birth it.
Yeah, right.
That's what he said. Listen, when God says, God says it.
Uh-huh.
God says it, means it, and it's perfect. And it doesn't have a debate. You ain't got to debate about it. You said, look at the book. The book says it says. Go read that. So y'all there? Let me read that. He said, what that? Oh, wait a minute. Companion of food. That means people that run around with food. You know that? Companion. Run around with food. Food. That's what it says. Look back at it. First Corinthians 15. Don't go back. Don't leave where you're at. I just want you to make sure you got that. Yeah, I want you to get the 15 to 33. Probably need to borrow through your Bible. That's where we started at. First Corinthians 15. And 33, mark it in your Bible. Because see now, and listen, I don't know about you, but God's good to me. Listen to me. Listen to me, church. Now, God is good. I was about 50,000 in debt. God bless, church. That's not there no more. I don't hate to do all this, but listen, when I bought the $35,000 tractor, but God, and then I turned around and bought an excavator, and God blessed, those were paid for. And one night I called a person that I was trying to buy a little piece of dirt. I called a person, I need a contract. Yeah, and so I got that. So listen, I don't know, and listen to me, you can act like you want to act, but God's been good to me. Yeah. God has blessed me, and he showed me how to handle it. Yeah. And listen, it's not because I'm so smart, because I'm sure not the smartest knife in the bar. But I got a good God.
Amen.
And I can't tell you, you go ahead and take the money. I'll take favor.
Yes,
yeah, they said because God was with Joseph. And God had favor. Yeah, they said, go ahead, but I'll take the money. I'll take the favor. Any day of the week. Because when God got favor on you, man can't bother you.
Amen.
I don't care what he done. And many times have been on a job site, and instead of me getting the job, they gave it to the other man.
All right.
With the other color. But God has favor.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Many times that when I lost, that's the thing about God. But when I lost the lease on the property, now God gave me more property, uh-huh, the lease, and it's more.
Uh-huh.
See, that's why you can't mess with God. That's why you need to watch what God's doing. Watch what God's doing, not what you're doing.
Right.
Walk with what man? Go ahead and finish up that. I'm going. I won't learn how to tell time money today, but that's all right.
That's part of that. The companion food shall be destroyed.
I'm going to be there long. And I'm kidding. Listen, church. Do what you want to do. Act the food if you want to act. Mm-hmm. But God sees all.
All right.
Yeah, God sees all.
Amen.
All right. I quit.